Hello.
Hello.
Who are you?
My name is Megan.
And Cameron.
And we're from Prince Edward Island.
Hey. Prince Edward Island. I love that. Well, now we need to know, what do you do?
We do testing everybody's horse in this very room.
Through dance.
What's your biggest dream?
Of being a superhero.
You want to be a superhero. I love that. And you want to dance.
I want to dance.
Are you nervous?
I'm so nervous and so scared.
Don't be scared. Aren't we all cheering them on?
Yes.
We're all cheering them on. Canada is cheering you on. Best of luck. The stage is yours. I'm so excited.
Now I have the time of my life.
No.
Dirty dancing.
I've been waiting for so long. Now
yes.
I finally found someone to stand by. Woo! Me.
Can I just say something? You are such an inspiration. You really are.
Thank you.
It's amazing that you do what you do. It doesn't matter what your hurdle is. And I know there's a lot of young boys who would love to go dirty dancing with their teacher.
can I also say, and I want to be really, really honest here. You didn't look like a dancer to me. You know what you looked like? A superhero.
Oh, yeah.
A straight up superhero.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Cam, listen, even before you started, you were my personal superhero. So thank you for coming here tonight. Both of you did outstanding, and I really enjoyed it.
Why don't you start us off?
All right, I am going to start with a big yes, sir.
It's a yes from me. Thank you so much.
It is a big, big, big yes from me.
And four yeses. Whoa.
Congratulations. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I guess that was it.
Bye. They're just adorable.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Lisa.
How are you, my darling?
You look nice.
You look fabulous. We have met before, haven't we?
Yes.
Belisha invited us to come and audition today, didn't she?
Yes.
for everybody here, tell us a bit about yourselves and what you're going to be doing and why.
Well, for Nathan, this is such a special moment to get to perform for everybody and show that you really have a passion for something, then you can achieve really great things. As you can see, he's got a wonderfully cheeky personality and just thrives on dancing. And we are very excited because today we're going to perform Nathan's favourite dance, which is the...
Cha-cha-cha.
Oh, we love cha-cha-cha.
For you, Bruno.
Oh, for me, my darling. Oh.
Yeah, darling.
Oh, yeah.
And all please, stand up, say shouting, slapping, and tear. Come on.
Whenever you're ready, good luck!
Yeah.
Cheeky, sizzling, joyous cha-cha-cha. You've given me that. You've given me the shape. You were working it, honey. Keep doing it.
Made it day.
Amanda?
Nathan, I feel so proud of you. Your footwork was brilliant. Your facial expressions were everything. You were just amazing.
We do get good dancers who are very boring on this show. But both of you have got such amazing personality. Even before you started, I think every single person in this theatre was just going, just be brilliant. And you were brilliant. And everything about this audition, I've got to tell you, I love.
Oh, Joanne, thank you so much for nominating Nathan. Nathan, thank you for being such a superstar today and making us all feel joy. You've really moved me. Thank you.
Can I be the first to say yes, please?
Amanda?
It's a yes from me.
Yes! Bruno?
It's a yes from me.
And it's a yes. huge yes from me. Congratulations.
Welcome to AGT.
Hi.
Thank you.
What's your name?
My name is Zion Clark.
And how old are you?
I'm 25.
And where are you from?
I'm from Canton, Ohio.
Okay. Can you tell me your story a little bit? Give us a little bit of background.
Yeah, so I'm from Canton. I grew up with neither of my parents. I was in the foster care system for the first 17 years of my life.
Mother's in prison, dad's in jail. I was thrown into the system the second I left the hospital.
Now, Zion, can you describe to America what is the condition that you were born with?
Yeah, it's called caudal regression syndrome.
Okay.
There's practically nothing known about it for the fact that it's super rare, aside from the fact that I don't have legs.
Mm. Now, tell me, what was that like?
I was disabled and a foster kid, so I was just thrown away. They're collecting the money. I was less than human, is what I was treated like. And I got scars all over my body to prove it. I was able to overcome these things because I learned how to fight and wrestle. I'm going through about 13, 14 different homes until the time I was about 17.
When did you get out?
Like, I was about to age out and be homeless, actually. And I got adopted by my mom.
How did you meet her?
The foster system said, we don't know where to put this kid. And they went to her and was like, hey, we have this kid. We're gonna throw him out. Would you take him in? And she said, yeah. I got adopted, everything came into place. My grades went up in school. Like, she's patient, but she's tough at the same time. Like, wouldn't let me quit nothing. Like, I tried quitting wrestling, and she wouldn't let me quit.
How far did you get?
I became one of the top three wrestlers in the state of Ohio, but I lost about 200 something times in a row.
In a row?
Yeah.
In a row?
Yeah.
Over 200 losses, you start winning.
Yeah. She really turned my life around and showed me my own potential.
Wow. Is your mom here today?
No, she's not here. I wish she could be there. Hi, Mom.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
If you had any advice for anybody aspiring to accomplish some dreams, what would it be?
Learn how to fail. I failed so many times that why can't you? I want to be on AGT because today I am going to show you what it means to have the feeling of no excuses running through your body.
Yes! No excuses.
You're amazing.
Yeah.
The stage is yours. Go ahead, buddy.
Absolutely.
All right.
Wow.
My name originally was Zion Zachariah Daniels. That's the name my birth mother gave me. I don't know my birth parents, and I don't know why they named me Zion, but I know that it's a mountain mentioned in the Bible.
It's where people supposedly went to protect themselves from the evils of the world. I know about the evils of this world. I survived for 16 years in the foster care system. I was abused physically and mentally by those who were supposed to protect and nurture me. Society said I would never amount to anything, but I chose to walk on my two hands instead of the wheelchair they put me in. I chose to represent the Team USA wrestling team, and every time I lost a match, I got back up again and became an All-American wrestler. I chose to join Pro MMA, where I won my first fight against an able-bodied opponent. I chose to earn 3 Guinness World Records for the fastest man on 2 hands. The highest box jump. And the most diamond push-ups.
Amazing.
I chose a life of no excuses.
Tremendous grit.
Life is gonna try to make you fold. But when you choose to climb that huge mountain, overcome the obstacles put in your way, carve your own path in order to reach the summit, you will reach the top. My name is Zion, and I made it here to America's Got Talent to show the world that anything is possible.
I'm so happy that you came to audition. I'm so happy that we met, and I have to say that you're very, very handsome too.
Very. But you know what I love? It's your smile. I mean, from the moment you arrive, you look like you're so happy, you know, and so many times we think our world and our life are hard, but I mean, I can't imagine what it's happened to you, and still here you come with a smile. Thank you for coming to AGT.
Thank you.
You know, we use the word amazing a lot, but I think it really applies to who you are. And I want everybody to watch you, to know you, to just, you need to be, you are very, very, very important.
Simon?
Well, I am so happy you came on our show. You've no idea, because you have such an incredible personality. You defined the word inspiration. I listened to everything you said. How you've come through this with this attitude is remarkable. And honestly, for me, this is what this show absolutely is all about, which is meeting talented people who you're going to remember and you're going to make a difference. And I applaud you. Amazing. One day,
when the glory comes, I'd like to start off. I want to give you your first yes.
Yes. Yes.
Heidi.
I want to give you a second yes.
Sophia.
Three yeses.
Simon.
I'm not going to give you four yeses. I'm going to give you 4 million yeses.
Onto the store there, have a chat with them. Good luck out there.
Good luck, pal.
Hello.
Hello. What's your name, please?
My name is Musa Motha. I'm originally from South Africa, but I've recently moved to London.
Oh, you did? Fantastic. Tell me about you, please.
I got diagnosed with cancer when I was young. That's led to the amputation. And I was a football player before I got amputated. And then after my amputation, I fell in love with music. My friends, they were dancing at that time. I asked them to teach me how to dance. So they threw like boxes on the floor, and then they were like, okay, this is how you do it. Your left crotch, use it as a left leg. And then that's how it started. And then I'm in London, I'm in UK, I'm in my favorite country, England. This is the perfect time for me to actually reach out to more people and inspire a lot of people out there. And
That's incredible. So, how long have you spent preparing for this audition?
Since I think forever, I've been imagining myself on stage, and now it's happening. I'm like,
yeah, I get it. Okay, well, look, no more questions.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you. I hope you enjoy.
Can you imagine what he's been through?
No. No.
change the way I feel. The way I feel. I'm standing still. Nothing else matters now, you're not here. So where are you? I've been calling you. I'm missing you.
Something beautiful. angry man.
That's who I am.
You really are.
It's fantastic.
Come here. That was one of the most amazing things I've ever seen in all the years I've done this show. Genuinely. Amazing. Look at this.
Look, but this is not us.
It's for you. It's not for us. It's for you.
Take your bow.
If these wings could fly.
Never ever heard a reaction like that in my life. Thank you.
I'm the true believer and a true example of breaking the word impossible into two. I am possible. I thank you so much.
Absolute hero.
Hi.
Hello.
What's your name and your age?
My name is Ahren Belisle, and I'm 28 years old.
Okay. And what is your talent?
Well, I can't dance. So I'm gonna do stand-up comedy.
Oh, wonderful! How long have you been doing this?
I did my first open mic about a year ago.
What got you into comedy?
Last winter, I ended up in Portugal. I ended up going to a comedy show there and making all the comics laugh, and they convinced me to try it.
Wow. So, comedy generally is about timing. What is your process?
Please hold while the operator types his response. To do my comedy, I use a text-to-speech app. Interestingly enough, the silence while I type just builds tension during a set, and I think people enjoy watching me laugh at my own joke that I'm writing. You should also know that if you heckle me, my service dog is trained to go for the vocal cords.
Can I ask, do you have a day job?
I'm an engineer.
So, young man, the stage is yours. Best of luck.
Most of you look super confused right now, so let's talk about the elephant in the room. I know what you're all thinking. Who ordered Stephen Hawking off of Wish.com? He might be smarter than me, but I would beat him in a race. Unless the race is downhill, then I'm screwed. Oh. We also have different conditions. He had amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, and I am Canadian. Specifically, I'm half French, on my left side. I also have a brain muscle disability called cerebral palsy, but being French is way worse than a brain disability.
Wow.
I used to have the word handicapped in my social media bio, and then some random white lady messaged me telling me I need to change it to disabled.
Oh!
You can't say that word anymore. It is offensive to disabled people.
I don't think it's offensive. Last time I checked, I was pretty disabled.
Well, you don't get to decide what is offensive or not to disabled people.
Who the hell does then? Some two-legged, white woman on Facebook, who is probably commenting on her phone from a handicapped bathroom stall. Thank you for listening.
Funny, fearless. Your dog is beautiful. It was just a great, great, great audition. This, I think, is going to change your life.
From the moment you started, you were funny, making fun of yourself, your energy. You're having such a good time up there. I hope that you are the one comedian that finally wins AGT.
I love how you found your way. I think you're very clever, you're cheeky, and you really were really funny. I mean, we were all laughing. It was fantastic.
I cannot believe you've only been doing this for 1 year, because you seem to have a grasp of timing and humor. You open up the conversation and normalize humanity and originality, and you're funny. I think, sir, you're not going to be doing engineering much longer. I think you're going to be full-time performing. That's my prediction. So I'm going to start off the voting with a yes.
And you're getting a big, fat yes from me.
Sophia?
Yes.
That makes it 4 yeses.
Funniest things I've ever seen in my life. Al loved it. He didn't have to choke anybody. I saw that. It was good. I held him back.
Disability or no disability, he was good,
really,
right?
Good.
He was like just...
Hello, what's your name?
Hello, my name is Lee, and for obvious reasons, I'm also known as the Lost Voice Guy.
Okay, and how long have you lost your voice?
I just knew you were going to ask something that I hadn't thought about beforehand. So please excuse the awkward silence while I type out my answer. I've been speechless for 37 years.
Wow. Tell me why you decided to enter the show this year.
I think I entered Britain's Got Talent for the same reason everyone does. To meet Anton Deck.
Yay! Really?
This is all going so well up until that point. The stage, Lee, is yours.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. As you may be able to tell, I'm a struggling stand-up comedian who also struggles to stand up. To be honest, I'm not sure how good I am. I'll leave that for you to decide. But just so you know, if you don't laugh at the disabled guy, you are going to hell. When I realized I'd never be able to talk again, I was speechless. I have lived in Newcastle all my life.
Yes!
But for some reason, I still haven't picked up the accent. I can see that some of you are trying to figure out where you know me from. Maybe it would help if I started saying phrases such as, "The next train to arrive on platform 4 is the 12:52 service to London King's Cross." And, from my time at the post office, please go to cashier number 8. I got the train here today. I always like to sit in those seats for disabled people. I was about halfway here when another disabled person got on and asked me to move. I didn't realize I'd be playing disabled top trumps when I got on, or I would have dressed more special. Needless to say, I didn't give up my seat. Who cares if he was both blind and deaf? I was there first. It was very awkward. He couldn't see that I was still there. And I couldn't tell him I wasn't moving because I can't speak. Before I leave you, I have one more thing to say. I hate that we have so many, politically, correct words to describe disabled people now. It's all special needs. Special schools, Special Olympics. I don't know what is so special about me. That is why it always alarms me when I hear about special forces going to war. You've been a fantastic audience. Goodbye.
Right, 'cause all those dreams are mine.
tale, direct, pentru că ești foarte talentată și pentru că meriți să fii acolo.
Mulțumesc!
Mă bucur enorm pentru tine.
Mulțumesc!
Este o minune, două!
My name's Jack.
Jack. Jack.
Carroll.
And how old are you?
14 years.
And tell me a little bit more about you.
I'm a professional gymnast.
My name's Jack Carroll, I'm 14, and today I'm going to be doing a bit of stand-up comedy. I've had cerebral palsy since I was born. And yeah, basically, still got it, won't go away.
It's impossible for him to move around without some kind of aid, either a wheelchair or a walking frame. But that seems to be the least of his worries. His big worries are whether his jokes make people laugh or not.
I use my cerebral palsy in my act because in comedy, a lot of times, your weaknesses are your strengths. It's like the elephant in the room, and then when you mention it, they go, and they can relax and enjoy the rest of the funny jokes.
He wants to make people laugh and he wants to make something of his life, and yeah, I'm really proud of him.
I'm not looking to help people in need because I'm a horrible, selfish individual. But if people do find some comfort or some inspiration from what I do, then brilliant bonus. I'm never gonna be Usain Bolt, right? That's sorted. But maybe I can focus on my strengths, which is, you know, bring joy to the world.
All right, well, best of luck.
All right, cheers. Don't worry, I know what you're thinking. Harry Potter's had a nasty Quidditch accident. Do you know what I can't stand? Sorry, let me re-emphasise. Do you know what? I can't stand. But look on the bright side. I've never had to queue at Disneyland. Now, I'm just going to throw a disclaimer out there. If I do get too energetic, please stop me. I want to keep my benefits. otherwise, how would I heat the jacuzzi? I'm joking. It's a pool. I was at the cinema seeing the new James Bond film the other day, and it got me thinking, you know, maybe I would have liked to have had a go, you know, being James Bond, but obviously I'm a bit inhibited. Ah, Mr. Bond, I've been expecting you. No lift. But this isn't the first Britain's Got Talent event I've been to. I was actually at the live tour in Manchester, funnily enough, 2 years ago. And the staff, they couldn't have been more helpful, moving people out the way, getting us to a seat. And then when we finally got there, the view was just fantastic. And we sat down and my sister, she tapped me on the shoulder, turned round, and I'll never forget this as long as I live. She said, "Jack, we are so lucky you're disabled." You cannot take her anywhere. Thank you very much. I've been Jack Carroll. Goodbye.
Right, Jack. I'm going to have to go to David first of all.
Jack, you are a comedy genius.
Thank you.
I wasn't as funny as you are 14. I'm not even as funny now as you are at 14 years old. It was incredible. Every joke was a winner.
Thank you. Cheers. Thank you.
Jack, you made me laugh before the act even started, and
I know, I've got a funny face.
No, you just... Jack, the thing that's great is nobody feels sorry for you. You're self-deprecating, you're hilarious, and I think you've got a huge future.
Well, I've got to tell you, Jack, you've got one of the most refreshing attitudes. You made fun, you know, of what you've gone through, and you made it funny, which is really, really difficult. You've just got an incredible personality. And I'm really happy that I met you.
Thank you.
Come on, 4 yeses.
Okay, David, yes or no?
Gigantic yes.
Alicia.
100% yes.
Amanda.
Yes for me, Jack.
Thank you.
Jack, you have. I think you know what's coming. 4 yeses.
Guys, a couple?
Yeah. No, dance couple,
but you're not romantically linked.
No.
The last
girl.
The last girl.
All right, all right. He's stood right there. Yeah.
Good luck.
Have fun out there.
Hello.
Good evening.
What's your name?
I'm Gary.
I'm Paula.
And we're Strictly Wheels.
Strictly Wheels?
Yes.
What's your relationship?
We're really good friends. We've been friends together for about 10 years.
Just friends?
Just friends. I'm Gary, I'm 39, I'm from Manchester, and I'm an HR manager.
My name's Paula, I'm 40.
41. She's just had a break.
Haven't I?
Yes.
I'm Paula, I'm 41, and I do volunteer work.
Paula and I are best friends. We do loads together. Go down the pub together, have a few pints. We might find us on the dance floor down the local club. We've only been dancing together seriously for about 18 months.
I never in a million years would have put myself down as going to do dance. 17 years ago, I contracted MRSA when I had pneumonia, which really damaged my pelvis and my lower spine. I've been using a wheelchair full time for 8 years, but it doesn't stop me. I love dancing, I love going out with my friends. I just do things sitting down, that's all.
And do you think that you've got an act that's going to blow us away today?
Hopefully, it's something that you probably haven't seen before, so yeah.
All right, well, I wish you the best of luck. The stage is yours.
Like
David.
I just thought that was amazing. I mean, you turned what might have been a negative into a positive. And you did things that two dancers don't normally do. It was absolutely fantastic.
Very good.
Amanda, how you dance, your control of that chair and your muscle in your arm is unbelievable. You were fantastic, the pair of you.
I thought it was going to be a bit uncomfortable, you know, like quite slow. And then suddenly, Paula kicks off. You are much better than Gary, by the way.
But very good, and I think you're fun. I like you too.
Yeah, Gary and Paula, you've got such a great connection. That was beautiful to watch. Surprising, refreshing, unique. The guys have said it all, so I think we should put this to a vote. David.
I loved you. It's a yes.
Yes.
It's a yes from me as well.
It's a brilliant, positive, fabulous yes from me. Well done.
Simon.
You've got four yeses. Congratulations.
Well, four yeses, no buzzers, do the next round. Must be pleased with that.
Yeah.
I always dreamed to be on America's Got Talent since I was little.
Are you nervous?
A little bit.
Are these your parents?
Yes.
And what are you going to do on AGT?
To be singing and playing a piano.
Oh, you're gonna be singing.
Yeah. My biggest challenge is people look at me just as a blind person, not as a musician. But when I'm singing, I feel like a superstar.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Just be yourself.
Yeah.
Good evening. Thank you for coming to AGT. What is your name?
My name is Putri Ariani. I'm 17 years old. I'm from Indonesia.
Bravo! Putri, is this your first time in America?
This is my very first time. I'm so excited. I love all the things in here.
What is your talent?
I am a singer.
How long have you been singing?
Maybe since I was born.
And what is your dream?
My dream is being the biggest diva in the world, like Whitney Houston, and win a Grammy Award.
Oh, wow! Yes! Are you going to school now?
Yes, I'm in high school, but I hope that I can get in Juilliard College of Music for my college program.
Why AGT? Have you always wanted to come here?
I hope that I can win America's Got Talent so I can reach my dream.
Okay, we're so happy that you're here and excited. We want to see you.
Thank you so much.
Good luck.
She's so sweet.
So cute.
Yeah.
Does that mic feel like it's a good spot for you? Cool? Are the keys good?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Have fun.
You break my heart, break my heart.
make me so down in a loneliness. You sure left me when I did. Thought you were my person, being my prince, but I was wrong. Oh, baby, you changed your pain into the
Her voice is amazing.
Yes.
And you have father.
Yes, I'm father.
Very nice to meet you.
Yes, nice to meet you.
Does Putri have a step in a song?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You want to sing for Pokemon?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you want to sing it for you? Yes, thank you.
What did you want?
Well...
Another song? Did you like that one?
I just said to Putri, I like her voice so much.
Thank
I
you
want
so
her
much,
to
Simon.
Sing a second song, please.
The song is special for you, Simon.
Well, thank you.
To me.
so excited. I can't believe it. Actually, I can be here now.
It was amazing.
Thank you.
We're all mesmerized by you. Your voice, you're an angel.
Thank you so much.
I think you just used the word, you know? A lot of people don't believe in angels, and I think one just landed on our stage.
Thank you.
You're a superstar.
Yes.
You sounded so beautiful tonight, especially the very first song that you sang, like how you switched from your chest voice to your head voice, like
that's
how
my...
you...
Sorry? Yeah, sorry? That's my original song.
Oh,
thank
wow.
you.
That's even beautiful. More amazing.
Wow. Very, very,
wow.
very
good. Wow.
I thought it was like a pop song. It was so good.
You didn't even tell us that.
They're going crazy for you.
Thank you so much.
Well, I think we're all feeling the same thing. You're 17, you write songs, you've got an amazing distinctive voice.
Thank you so much.
I mean, really, really good. You have a kind of a glow about you. And tell me about, you're waiting for something at your school.
I really want to go to Juilliard.
Okay, I don't know whether this is gonna make a difference or not. However,
he's standing up.
A shark spirit won't come down. I'm gonna send a flood, gonna drown out. This is brave, this is bruised. This is who I'm meant to be. This is me.
Simon, can you say a little bit about why you pushed this golden buzzer?
Because she's brilliant.
Absolutely!
I don't
believe it. There's the gold.
Yeah.
What a moment, kinda.
One more time for Putri Ariani!
Hello, please introduce yourselves.
So I'm Jade, and what's your name? Christian. Christian is my little brother, and we're sign along with us.
How old are you?
I'm 18 years old, and how old are you, Christian?
Four.
He's four.
Oh, yeah. My goodness me. Fantastic. What are you going to do for us today?
So we're here to do some sign language and some singing.
Brilliant.
Thank you. We were told that Christian would never be able to communicate. I taught him sign language so then he could talk, and he's here, a little miracle, proving everybody wrong.
Yes, sister! That's what she's supposed to do.
I didn't want to accept that Christian would never be able to communicate. I just knew that there was a voice in there that needed to come out.
Exciting, isn't it? No. You're so cheeky.
Cheeky. We decided we wanted to teach other people this, so we started a class. We're just amazed by how many people wanted to get involved.
I'm Taylor and I'm 7.
I'm Sam, I'm 22.
I'm Ella and I'm 12.
Are you excited to see Sam and Cal?
Yes. Yeah. I'm in love with him anyway.
Ella has actually met Simon before. She won a Child of Courage Award at the Pride of Britain 2019.
You are the sweetest, bravest little girl and you deserve this. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Wow, I can't believe I'm on Bitter Cut Talent. It's amazing. It's made my dream come true.
Just gonna go out there and show them what we've got, aren't
yep.
we?
Yeah.
Try our best.
Amazing.
Yes. We would never normally get an opportunity to do something like this. It's unbelievable. We're just so excited.
We wish you all the best.
Say thank you.
Don't make me melt.
Such an anthem for people who maybe don't feel part of the world or part of anything. And I just found it really, really moving.
Thank
you. It was absolutely brilliant.
Hello, thank you. Gla-gla. Thank you.
I genuinely can't find the words.
Amazing!
Thank you.
And Christian, you are an absolute little star, so thank you.
Hey, thank you.
I have to confess, I have a friend of mine in this choir. Ella. We met at the Pride of Britain, and I heard Ella sing, and I said, I have a feeling one day you're going to be auditioning on one of our shows, and guess what? You're here. And you'd say, this is me, and I'm thinking, you are us, because you define what this show should be all about. This is an audition I will never, ever forget.
Thank you.
Every one of you gave everything to this performance, an amazing positive message to put out there. And all I can say is... Well done.
That's how you do it. That's how you celebrate a golden buzzer.
You did well done. It's a brilliant idea.
Oh, there you go. Come on. That's it. That's it. That's it.